Hello and welcome to Climbing Daily, and welcome Daniel Woods. It has been a long, long time. We're just saying like 2.5 years or something.
Yeah, it's been a while. It's great to be back.
So we're at the Arkose Climbing Gym. If you hear loads of noise, it's because it is super noisy because we're getting ready for a competition. Daniel, because it's been so long, let's just kind of catch up a little bit.
Sure.
So you were in Spain last year trying some super hard projects. Just describe what you're going for and how hard they really are.
Last year I was trying first round, first minute. That was my main objective and got pretty close, but wasn't able to put together. I came back this year and put like only 2 days into it, and the conditions were a little warm. I decided to bail and just climb some other routes, and now I'm in Switzerland, so I'll be there for the next month, and there's a lot of new boulders. I haven't been to Swiss since I was 18, so it's been a while.
It's expensive, just to warn you.
I know, it's pretty expensive actually, but the bouldering is some of the best granite bouldering in the world, so I'm pretty hyped to be there.
You seem to move so almost effortlessly between bouldering and sport climbing routes. Is that something that you're doing on purpose, or are you just trying stuff?
It's actually pretty difficult. I think I kind of had that awakening when I was just in Spain a few weeks ago. I was just bouldering in Red Rocks, trying a hard boulder, had no endurance preparation, went to Spain, and I was like, oh man, like this is heinous. And I tried to climb some easier routes for me, but I still was getting my ass kicked on those routes, and I was like, man, I should have trained before this. So if you're able to manage it and stay fit for both, it works, but I definitely was in way better bouldering shape, so I should have just kept bouldering. But also I was kind of sick of bouldering because I had been doing it for 4 months, so I just wanted to switch it up.
Do you find it's one of those things that the more you're on sport climbing routes, your fitness just comes back to you gradually?
Yeah, definitely. I was only in Spain for 2 weeks, and by the end of the 2 weeks, I felt like I had good resistance, but it was time for me to leave, so, and now I'm back into bouldering mode, but I haven't really lost my outdoor power, so hopefully that'll just transfer over fast, but yeah, it's definitely difficult.
Now, I really want to talk to you about MELLOW because we're a climbing media brand, and it's been so awesome watching this nugget sort of grow up on YouTube and like expand. You guys are putting out so much content. So for those of you who don't know what MELLOW is about, just sort of sell MELLOW a little bit. What do you guys do and what's it all about?
MELLOW is basically just like a climbing media hub, and it's just me, Sean Rabatou, Giuliano Cameroni, Jimmy Webb, Keenan Takahashi, and we got together and we just wanted to create videos for the climbing community to show like who we are, what we're about, have some personality in there, show hard climbs, you know, like just have an outlet where people can go and like just watch a ton of hard climbing videos. And hopefully, like, our goal is obviously to have quality over quantity, so we definitely can like improve on some of the quality, but for the most part I'm pretty impressed with what we've put out and the attention we've gotten and feedback. So we'll just continue to put out videos and get other people stoked to get their videos on MELLOW. And I don't know, it's kind of like a culture, you know, it's like not, we just want to bring everyone into our community and show them what we're about and stuff.
Oh, the raw side of it is very interesting, because usually with a climbing video, it's polished, it's edited to death. Yeah. You guys are putting out almost like just raw sends.
Yeah, so we have like basically two main sections right now. We have a part section, which is like the video will be a little bit more cut up. We'll show more personality, and it'll be like a part, you know. And then we also have an uncut section where it's like we just show an uncut send. So I think all of us, we just wanted to create, especially with the uncut, something where you can just go and you can watch something groundbreaking go down first try, no cuts, and not have to like, yeah, you can just get inspired that way. So yeah, it's pretty cool.
Has half your mom, because you know a rock climber's lifespan in terms of making money and keep on generating that is tricky as yeah, you get older. Have you still got an eye on the producing, filmmaking front for the future for yourself?
Yeah, I mean, I like, definitely my background's in rock climbing. I'm not like that professional in the video world or anything like that, but I've grown up in the climbing world. I've worked with a lot of sponsors, a lot of videographers and editors, and kind of just like learn from them. I also follow skateboarding pretty closely, so I looked at Thrasher, and we were looking at the skate world and being like, how are they doing it, and like we could just replicate the same thing in the climbing world, and that's what we're trying to do. So we're just trying to make something fun, something that's like raw, different, try to get that next generation involved too, and try to get them in the game, because I guess my whole goal is like that next gen coming up, being able to make an outlet where they can put videos on, get paid by their sponsors, go live the dream, and you know, like continue doing what they're doing.
Well, it's hugely appreciated, especially you. I mean, I just love watching every video that comes
That's
out.
Cool. So thank
you so much, man. I want to ask you very quickly about this sort of 9A bouldering grade, because it's something that once Gnarly put his climb up, it was like, oh, there's a 9A in the world. Then recently, No Capote Only has been climbed, which may be a 9A. Are you seeing this crest now when climbers are breaking into this 9A? And do you think we're going to see grades go up and down as climbers progress into it?
Yeah, I mean, I don't know, grades are just a way of gauging how hard you're rock climbing and stuff like that, and I feel like you can propose a grade, and that's cool, but in the end, it's like, well, like, what does your, like, pyramid look like? Like, what other hard test pieces have you repeated, not just in your hometown, but around the world, you know? And, like, so, yeah, like, a lot of AC Plus, 9A have been thrown out, and I haven't even tried half those, you know, but who knows, maybe they're really hard, maybe they're not AC Plus or 9A, but it's cool that grade's being thrown out there, because it's kind of showing, like, we're trying to progress bouldering. There was a lull for a moment where 8C was this just giant thing, and I definitely believe that a lot of 8Cs that we've climbed should be 8C plus. And yeah, sure, maybe we should have 9A right now. I think 9A should be a pretty special grade though still. It's like, I mean, I just recently tried the Sit Start to Sleepwalker in Vegas, got close to that, and I put like 25 days into it, and I was like, man, this thing feels like the next step in my climbing. But I've also done like five other 8C plus, numerous 8Cs, 8B plus, and I just feel confident enough now to be like, I could maybe climb 9A. So who knows, like, I haven't tried the thing Charles put up. It got repeated pretty quick. Who knows, maybe it's not 9A, but it's still 8C plus, or maybe it's 8C, who knows? I can't really judge that, but yeah, it's cool. People can keep proposing and we'll go try them and see what they're like.
It's super interesting hearing you talk, because I think it's very easy for a lot of people to sit on the internet and give comments, but like, you're one of a very few select people actually trying that, so it's good to hear your thoughts on it. Last thing I have to say to you is we have something on Epic TV called the 9B counter, which we started last year. And what we tried to do is like count up the number of 9Bs in the world and give a prize.
That's crazy.
Last year, Stefano Gasolfi won it. You came fairly close to winning it.
Wow, for 9B.
I know.
That's crazy. I don't even know half the 9Bs in the world.
it was an experience, silly. But this year we've sort of done something slightly stupid, which we've changed it from, we've got an 8C counter. So okay. It goes 8C, 8C plus 9A,
okay.
And then 9B, 9B plus 9C for sport climbing.
Okay.
I have my money on you okay. to win the overall. And I know you don't know this, but I'm just letting you know.
Well, thank you. You have a lot of confidence in me.
So from December next year, if you could just step it up until then,
okay.
Because I've got a bet with that man there and I need to win. So
okay,
please
so
try
how
on.
Many, how many 9Bs do I need to get under my belt? Well,
you need a few 9Bs, but okay. if you can get the top points on the 8C counter
okay.
and the 9B counter, okay. then you'd win the overall, and that's important for me.
Well, I have many 9Bs I'm still psyched to try this year, and I have hopefully one 9A that I'll go back to in December. And then I have a few 8C plus 8C on my list, so we'll try hard for you. We'll try hard.
Thank you, Daniel. Appreciate it. Mate, lovely talking to you. Good luck with the competition tonight.
We'll see you soon. This will be interesting because I haven't indoor climbed in a while, so but
it'll
whatever.
Be fine. What's the worst that could happen?
The worst that could happen is fall and break my leg or something. That would be pretty bad.
That is pretty bad, actually. There's free beer on offer, though, so you can kill
let's
it.
Chill,
kill the pain.
Chill. All right,
mate. Best of luck. Talk
Thank
to you soon.
Man. Thank you. Have a good one.